Okay, good morning. We'll discuss the numericals now. Let me do a setting here. Okay, start reading the question. Draw the diagram. I think you need a small diagram at least. So one particle is projected at an angle. So one of the particle one. So we'll take this particle one. It is projected at an angle theta. So what is the path? It's going to describe helical path. So the path of this will be other particle. Stay along x, t equals 0, its x coordinate is 50 centimeter. Somewhere here, the other particle. It is moving with a certain velocity, we don't know that, and this is projected with a velocity v1. Let's assume time being. So this is at t equals 0. 50 centimeter. The situation at t equal to zero. The two particles collide and stick together and the combined mass goes in a circular path. Find the possible values of the mass of the uncharged particle. I think the uncharged particle is this one. I think we have to read that conditions given carefully here. It's telling that after collision, the combined mass goes in a circular path. So what should happen to the momentum of the combined particle along x-axis should become zero. Only along y-axis should be there. And look at the b bar is in this direction. So x component of velocity should vanish after collision. So applying conservation of momentum, m1, v1. Uncharged particle. This is not a charge, no? So this will not have a charge. I'll make it. Yeah. So momentum should vanish. Final momentum, initial momentum. So m1 v1 cos theta minus m2 v2 should be equal to zero. Okay, this much is what we don't know, m2 and we don't know v also. These two are unknown. m1 v1 cos theta, we know it. Okay, keep this equation. Now the particle, where do it will collide? They will collide. They will collide on x-axis only. Then what is the time taken by it? 2 pi m by qb. So it can be, and anybody value of this?
(10^3).
Timer. 3 gram micro, micro is there, no? Micro here, we have 0.6 pi tesla. Pi will get cancelled, 10 to power of...
Milli by micros.
Milli by micro.
Only 1 mil
by 3.
Answer.
How much? I 1 second.
Yes, sir.
Somebody said milli, micro, no one.
One only,
sir. Not there.
I kept grams instead of kilograms.
Okay, that one. Yeah. 1 second. After every, so 1 second. So what are the times at which it can be? Particle A when it cuts the x-axis. So this should be the code to, shall we write here? This will be 1 second for our 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds, 5 seconds. That's all, no? Like this, what happened? It collide, and what is the x component of velocity? It will be 10 centimeter per second. This will be. So can we calculate the distance at which it's going to cut? Okay, this, let it be t only. They will collide on x-axis only. And what are the coordinates at which particle will cut the x-axis? Coordinate of particle at which it cuts x-axis. This t is 1 second, I know it. So this will be vx into t, 2 vx into t, 3 vx into t. I'm trying to generalize it. So these are no so and so, so on. So how long it is till less than 50 centimeters. There's a possible things are there. So 10 into this will be, I think how much it will be at 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, not possible now because at T equal to 50 it is projected. So anywhere between less than 50 centimeter only they'll collide. So I'll not write 5 vxt, keep it here. Now velocity, what velocity should be required by the second mass to collide? After what time? So they will collide after some time. Somewhere, let's assume that particle is here. So what is the distance moved by it? So shall we go for all the things? This will be. So let's assume that at 10 centimeter, they collide. So here. After 1 second, they'll collide. So then what is the 50 centimeter? You can write it as 50 is equal to this distance called by this 10 plus this particular thing, no? And it will take 1 second to collide. If it collides here, after 2 seconds it collides, I think now we can correlate. So what should be the velocity? Because you are going to project with only one velocity, not different velocities. How to bring that V2 now? So let it some x distance will collide. So how much of distance it will move? 50 minus x with a speed v2 into the time. So time of motion is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, like this we'll get it. So now find the possible values of the mass of uncharged particle. Okay, I think now why I'm possible values. Okay, I'll do one thing. 50 minus x should be equal to V2 into T. So what is V2 equal to? 50 minus X into T. Okay, now what is the possible value? Where do they can collide? If they collide at X equal to 10 centimeter. So let me take general here, this one. So V2 is equal to 50 minus 10. So what is the time taken? Will be 1. So what is the speed? 40 centimeter per second. Next, 50 minus 20 will be 15. Like this, one more, 50 minus 40 by 4. will be 2 point. Okay, these are the possible values of mass is asking. So how to bring this one? So I'll substitute that particular V2 values, then we'll get the corresponding M2. So this is equation one. These are all equation two.
Sir, instead of considering velocities, we can directly write that they'll collide at center of mass. We'll get one equation in n, like some integer and mass. From there, we can directly get the answer.
Any method. M2 equal to V2, you write it. So substitute the different values of V2. put two in. Put different values of equation two in one. So you get the corresponding values of M2. Anybody values?
Four point five twelve.
Okay, now so these are some, see, like a simple ideas. You can apply any concept. I just maintained a little bit simplicity in the problem. Now this will be our final answer.
Milligram.
Oh, mg. Okay. No, here mg is there. An interchange symbol. Yeah. I'll take the next one. I'll scroll down. Okay, we'll take the next one. And this, I think, already came in question paper. Once again, let me put it. So this is the, just read the question. You might have forgotten. If you're able to recollect, okay, fine. Value of B bar dot DL for that particular wire. Look at the wire. Wire lies in XY plane. And he has drawn an ampere circuit loop in XZ plane. It's asking the value of B bar dot DL. Okay, the total structure will be. So let's make it a plane diagram. Okay, this is the, so this is the wire. Okay, this is the y-axis, this is the x-axis, this is the z-axis. Now, where is the Amperian loop? Amperian loop is lies in xz plane. I'll bring negative x-axis also. Able to understand? So this is the Amperian loop. So where the radius is smaller is equal to how much it is? R by root three, the radius of this particular thing. So here it is asking us the value for this particular loop. Okay, fine. So this is the direction of current is something like this. So Amperian loop lies in XZ plane. So what is the radius of the loop? Radius of the loop will be R is equal to root three. So this problem, you just make it. Let me assume the same diagram. Semi-infinite. Can we assume now another wire? I'll make it a complete loop. It'll be easy for us to write. Now, where is Ampérean? Ampérean loop is here now. So what is the net current enclosed by the Ampérean loop? Mu naught I, but this is what assumed, we brought it. Okay, there's a straight wire and there's a arc. We'll have this one. And what is the net, and this is what that, this is what you bring that DL. Fine. Now let's write. What is a net B bar dot DL? B bar dot DL will be due to. I need some space. Let me push it here. This is the logical thinking what we are bringing here now. So don't go for any integration. Without integration, you can solve this. So the total B bar dot DL for a loop should be equal to B bar dot DL this is due to straight wire, this is due to arc. But what is being asked? They are asked for arc. I'll find out for the loop. In that, if I subtract this due to straight wire, I'll get due to arc. The value of B bar dot DL. Okay, the symbols, if you want, I'll retain that. So what is the value of this? This should be equal to mu naught I, but we don't know due to straight wire. That has to be determined. So how to determine due to straight wire? Where on this one? So what is the radius R? What is the value of this? So this straight wire, how much of angle it will? Yeah, let's get into this one. shall we assume this to be, what is the length of this? Should be 2R. Length of this wire should be 2R. And what is small r equal to? R by root 3. So can we get alpha beta? So tan alpha is equal to 2R by R by root 3. So 2 root 3 is what? Tan alpha value.
R by root 3.
R by R root 3, no? So tan alpha is root 3. So any, what should be the value of alpha?
60 degrees.
Even same thing with beta. Now, do we know the value of B bar dot DL due to straight wire? B bar dot DL, this is not B bar. We know B bar. Integral of B bar dot DL. Can you remember I just modified the Ampere circuit law for a finite wire? You have to recollect. I gave one formula. Mu naught I by 2 pi D. Okay, I'll write down.
That pi D will not be, sir. Mu naught I by 2.
mu naught I pi d should be there, no? There's a formula is what we have modified it. Can you remember this? First, you have to go for, I think most of you might have forgotten, Ampere's circuit law. I told you it's not there in book, but plenty of numericals will be dumped based on this idea. Let's get into. Okay, now it's only about the calculation, no? Just wait, I'm getting one message. Let me read message and I'll come back. Okay, come. Okay, now. So do we know value? Alpha and beta, everything we know. So therefore, this will be equal to how much? Mu naught I by 2. Sine 60, this will be root 3 by 2, root 3 by 2. So this will be mu naught I root 3 by 2. So that I'll substitute here. So according to this equation, let me do a calculation. So this will be equal to how much? Mu naught I root 3 by 2 plus B bar dot DL due to arc. This is our answer. Unless you don't know that B bar dot DL bar for a finite wire using Ampere circuit, I don't think so. This is question cannot be solved. You have to be very careful. Some standard ideas that follow here. Let me go for the next one. So draw the diagram. So it's telling there's a parallel plate capacitor. Separated by a distance D, much smaller than the edge length. Side length is A. Okay, no. It is charged to a potential difference V. And moved with a constant velocity. V naught, I'll write it a potential so that it'll be easy for us. And moved with a constant velocity V directed along one of its edge. They are moved with a constant velocity V. How much magnetic field exists inside the capacitor? Directly straight away, what is this? There'll be a charge residing on the plate in inner surfaces only. So it is like as good as you are moving a non-conducting, a charged sheet. Then what is the field due to non-conducting charge sheet? If you can straight away, you have to go back to the concept. Suppose if this is the, once again, I'll take you back to the basics. Please do remember some such things because application questions will come. So this is a charge sheet, no? Upper one is charge sheet, lower one is a charge sheet. I'll just show the, okay, for my convenience, let me do like this. So they charge. No, so let this be, it is moved with a velocity v. Let me assume a strip. Okay, already I discussed, once again I'm revising it. Let me assume a strip. So let the width of this be dr. So let this be equal to dx. Or DL, whatever you want, you can write it. Let me take DL. Same symbols I'll use. What are they used? So this is having a charge density sigma. Can we define sigma? Sigma should be equal to charge Q by A square. And what is in turn Q? Charge Q should be equal to, this should be plus Q minus Q, no? So Q should be equal to capacitance C into V naught. Capacitance is what? Epsilon naught A square by D. So Q by A square, what we can write it as? Q by A square, epsilon naught V naught by D. So where all that sigma is there, I can replace with these terms, what I needed. Now look at this. This is like a, some sort of like a charge. Due to rate of flow of charge, there should be current. So this whole sheet, now what we can replace? This is like a, as if current is coming out of the plane. Okay, agree this? As if the current is coming out of the plane. So how the B bar, here B bar should be? So here, what shall we do now? So shall we assume a Amperian loop? So that B into dr. So here only, let me combine both the diagrams. Yeah, let it be this one. Very small. I know this is what this structure what we assumed. So many symbols, you'll get confused. Let me use the first diagram symbols only. What is dr? So shall we put dr, this particular distance, and the field here will be in this direction. So what about the value of B bar dot dr? Here it will, B bar dot dl will be zero, no? Because there is no magnetic field here. We'll assume that one. So here it should be equal to 2, or say like B dr plus B dr should be equal to net current enclosed. Put I net. So 2 B dr. Now what should be the I net? I net should be equal to the amount of charge that is present here, dq by dt. Now what is the charge present in that region? Should be equal to sigma into dq, should be equal to sigma into dl into dr, no? By this is dt. So dr gets eliminated. So 2b equal to mu naught sigma dl by dt. What is dl by dt? That should be the velocity. Look at the, how the velocity vector will be. dl by dt should be the velocity vector. So therefore, this will become finally, this is our velocity v. So therefore, what is b equal to? Mu naught sigma v by 2. This is due to upper plate, due to positive charge plate. Now let's take help of both the plates. Let's draw the both the plates. Just you have to fight with the conditions given. this will behave like as if it will produce a field in this direction, and there's a negative charge plate. No current will be into the plane, so this will in what direction this will produce field in this direction. So therefore, what happened to net field between the plates of capacitor should get added up. So the net field should be equal to 2B. So this should be equal to mu naught sigma V. But sigma is what we assumed it, no? So shall I bring this equation here? Small objective questions can be asked in exams. This will be the field between the plates of capacitor. Mixed ideas, always put effort once. It'll be on safer side. So now I suggest you have to really remember this particular thing. You have to start every numerical here. That's what I think in exam they expect. Whenever a charge sheet is moving with a velocity v, then you can use this particular formula. And all the velocity v should be tangential to surface of the plate. Mu naught sigma v by 2. Please do remember this formula. So actually, if you start from here, I think very simple, no? Only thing is you have to assume something like this. Within 2-3 lines, you can end up. If you don't know this particular formula, you should really think this one. This is what I think makes a difference in exam. You know concept, but if you forget something, yes, you are going to lose time. rolling idea is introducing here. Okay, these are the two parallel strips. So on that, cylinder. Unable to make it. Or you can go for plane diagram. Let me try out. I'll put a cylinder, some brown color. Yeah. Hope I think I'm able to. Yeah. Please do understand, more than this I can't do. No, this is what the strips here. So now B bar is what directed vertically. So here this is the direction of B bar. A current I is to make to flow through it. So directly apply the Fleming's left hand rule, B bar current. So a force will act through the center of mass. They are rough. So a friction will act, resultant friction you can write it as F equal to 2F dash. So then if you go for plane diagram, this will be the condition. There's a radius R, the force F. Here you show friction. I think this will be quite very easy for you know. So this will be acceleration of center of mass. This will be torque. Write down the equation now. F minus small f equal to mac. Then torque F into R should be equal to solid cylinder alpha c. For pure rolling, AC equal to R alpha c. I think now you can replace F. F will be mac by 2. What is F? F equal to BIL. Wherever you want, you can introduce this idea. What is the speed of the rod at any time? AC into T. What is the angular velocity? Omega into alpha CT. What is the work done by friction? So many other parameters can be introduced here. So you can bring this on inclined plane. In that case, instead of here, mg sin theta will come into picture, and also BIL force. So I think such numericals is what you came across in EMI chapter. Any other ideas you can propose here? So torque due to like this BIL force, what happens? It does only translative work. It will not set up a way to show this F to the center of mass. Provided open, this rod is having uniform distribution. Suppose like a center of mass, like if a non-uniform distribution is there, density is non-uniform, then where do this F will act? F should act through the center of mass. There's a rule. Where do this ampere force will act? Through the center of mass of the system. I think you have come across in center of mass chapter where the linear mass density of the rod varies. There's a thin rod. This is cylinder also, you can check the density. This will be heavier, density is more here, less. Then this F, you have to show it somewhere here. In that case, it may not be exactly, cannot go, because it may try to rotate also. So the problem they made simple. So any questions they can ask. So the F you have to show through center of mass of system. That you remember it. An uniform magnetic field is switched on along x-axis. Find the initial angular acceleration of the frame above the given axis of rotation, neglecting gravity. Now take the acceleration due to gravity g along negative z-axis. Find the minimum current through the frame such that the frame remains in equilibrium. Oh, look at the frame. It is made to rotate about some fixed axis. No, look at the axis. Is it passing through center of mass? No, it is not passing through center of mass. Am I right? So any condition can be put. Okay, as usual, what about torque due to dipole moment? See, wherever you suspend the loop, what is the torque due to dipole moment? Current into area, there is a dipole moment, and the torque will be set up. I think in that way only we should analyze this particular given problem. So first we'll calculate the torque due to dipole moment. first dipole moment how much? M naught as that, because other mass is 4m, no? M naught is equal to current I naught into L square, then torque due to dipole moment should be equal to M bar cross M naught bar cross B bar, M naught B sine 90 I naught L square into B. This is a torque. What is the sense of this? It will rotate about along y axis only. It will rotate. It is made to rotate about along y axis here. Positive y axis, the torque is set up. Is it okay? M naught will be along k cap. See, that's what I suggest you. Like, what about the direction? What about the direction? So, if you look at the direction, should be, shall we put k cap? So sorry, j cap. Sir, how do you can say? M naught is along k cap, k cross I will be j. The torque is set up about that point. So let me show that. So there's a loop. That you are making it to rotate forcibly, you're making it to rotate. this is what you can show torque due to dipole moment. So he's asking that angular acceleration. So what is angular acceleration? Should be torque due to dipole moment by moment of inertia about this axis. PP dash, let me write. How to calculate moment of inertia of this? This distance is L by 4. So therefore moment of inertia M L by 4 whole square. M 3L by 4 whole square 2 into ML square by 2L M L by 4 whole square. Why? So it has become so much of big. Look at the axis of rotation. It is not passing through center of mass of this rod. No, L by 4 is there. The first moment of inertia of this rod M into L by 4. L by 4 whole square. This whole mass will be at a distance 3L by 4. So M into 3L by 4 plus moment of inertia of this rod and this rod. So you should apply parallaxis theorem about its center of mass, ML square by 2L plus M into this distance is how much? L by 4 whole square. Fine. So this will get the instantaneous angular acceleration. Next again. Find the minimum current through the frame such that the frame remains in equilibrium. Now the weight is brought into picture. How the torque due to dipole moment will be clockwise, no? Actually. Then where the weight will act? The weight will act through this particular point. So how I should send the direction of current? Same current, or shall I reverse the direction of current? So I think I'll go for some, we'll have a diagram like this. This is that axis. So torque due to weight, how do it will act? The weight of the loop will act vertically down. So it will set up L by 4 is the distance. This axis, PP dash, fine. So torque due to weight, let me show in this way, it'll be easier. Now for it to be equilibrium, how the torque due to dipole moment should be? Should be in opposite sense. For this, what shall I do? I should reverse the current here. How B bar will be directed tangentially. So look at now how M bar will be vertically down now. So M bar cross B bar will be anti-clockwise about this one. Minimum current is asking. So therefore, this should be equal to.
So torque due to magnetic field will act in the opposite direction.
Correct, no?
Not opposite to torque due to weight, sir. Like the direction what you wrote, opposite to that.
Yeah,
The
look at
first
the current.
figure it is right, sir. In the second figure.
This one, huh?
Sir, torque due to magnetic field, sir.
Torque
It
due to
isn't.
magnetic field will be clockwise, sir.
So I don't know. This diagram only.
Yes, sir. In the second diagram, it is wrong.
So second means this one, huh? I'm not getting. Okay, I think I'll give a number. This is the second diagram. This is the first diagram. Yeah.
In the first diagram, you got torque as clockwise. In the second diagram, you wrote torque due to magnetic field anti-clockwise.
And because torque due to weight should be balanced, no?
Yes, sir. It should be balanced, but in the question, you should have given B along the negative x direction.
No. Same thing. See, I have to change current also, no? I should change the magnitude. I should change direction also. I cannot keep the same direction. How it is equilibrium point? Saying equilibrium means I should change the direction of current also. Otherwise, if I put current, if I change the direction of current, both will act in same direction. So equilibrium not possible, no?
Yes. Any one thing we can change.
Okay. I changed it current. Let me change current because he is asking minimum current, no? So there's a possibility for me to control magnitude and direction. Huh? Mg by 4bl.
Mgl by 4, no, sir.
Sir, it will be 4m, no, sir. 4 rods.
Four rods. Okay, that. Mg by BL. What is that equilibrium? Stable, unstable? How to decide? More than one options. There's a minimum current. How to decide equilibrium stable, unstable?
Unstable.
Displace
it.
So if you can displace it, let me displace clockwise, then torque due to weight will decrease. Then torque due to dipole moment. Earlier, what is the angle between M bar and B bar? Was 90, no? So this is what B bar. We will just analyze through the diagram. This is the M naught bar. If you displace, B bar will not change. If you displace it, so slightly this M bar will take direction of like this here. Then a torque due to weight will also decrease here. Sine of 90 plus some theta. Can we say stable or unstable equilibrium?
Neutral, I think.
Neutral.
To small angle. Yeah, to small angle theta, if you bring it, no? Similarly, by what quantity torque due to dipole moment decreases, due to same quantity, the weight due to weight also decreases. I think we have to show that mathematically. We have to assume this theta. Similarly, what will happen? So this will be Mg. Both, how much it will be? L by 4 cos theta, that will be neutral equilibrium.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. Yeah. Verified, huh?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I'll just put like loop is in neutral equilibrium. if you are finding difficult, no, you can take help of force. So what about the torque due to force acting on each arm? Through that, what happened? Also, you can bring this particular thing. That will be more safer side. Huh? If you want, you can think in that way also. Because we know the axis. We are very sure about the axis. No, so okay. We know the force acting on each arm. With that also, you can bring this equation. If there is no axis, tell me what happened to this torque due to dipole moment. Where do it act? It will act through this particular thing. It will act through its axis passing through center of mass. Since it is acting parallel to the axis passing through center of mass, no, so therefore the effect, what happened, we are unable to notice that difference. So if you are getting confusion, take help of force on this arm, force on this arm, force on this arm, force on. I think there won't be force due to these two arms. So only due to these two arms will come. Calculate the torque, it will be equal to this much only in magnitude. That is more correct method than blindly writing this one. Are you getting my point? So I'm trying to stress some. So this will be L by 4. B naught, B I naught L, L by 4. Here, B I naught L, 3 L by 4. Both the torques, the difference of that you calculate, finally you end up the same answer. Slight confusion or anything complex, take help of the basic. I think the diagram, yeah. Little bit some confusion is there. Let me clarify the diagram. So this is the semicircular arc. Four centimeter. Look at this, this basic, this is radius R. This axis AB, there's a uniform magnetic field, you'll switch on, is asking instantaneous angular acceleration. It is free to rotate about axis CB. And I'll pass a current I. Even if it is in different plane also, but the question is given only this much of information. What is the magnitude of its angular acceleration? I think it's all about calculating moment of inertia. Because how M bar will be, I think I'll, oh yeah. M bar and B bar will be perpendicular. So we know dipole moment, this one. So what is the angular acceleration? Should be equal to M B by moment of inertia. Okay, this should be equal to current IAB. A moment of dipole moment, how much it should be equal to I naught into area of this, shall we do one thing? We'll give some symbols. LB plus pi r square by 2 into B by moment of inertia. Moment of inertia of this have to be determined. So the, what is the lambda? Lambda, this is lambda, lambda. Lambda straight wire, circular wire is lambda by 2. Okay, let's calculate moment of inertia. So this should be equal to lambda into B will be the length, B square by 3. Like this, two are there, two straight rods. Then lambda into L, B square. Okay, this is about any diameter. This are able to understand. So lambda B is the length of this rod into B square by 3. Same thing this also. These two rods will have same moment of inertia about A and B. What about this rod? Is it a distance B? What is the mass of this rod? Lambda into L. Lambda into L, B square. Now we have to calculate the of this wire. So it is half of the ring, no? About any diameter, how much it will be? MR square by 2. About any diameter, off of that I'll remove it. So therefore, M is how much? Lambda by 2. Length is pi r. Check it this. What is the mass of the ring? Lambda by 2 into perimeter is pi r into, so it is like a half of that one, no? So r square by 2, I'll write it. I think you should have given some plane diagram, some. So that I think everything we are assuming correct, no? Yeah. So I'll do one thing. This will be more meaningful. Huh? Okay, what all the data? 4 centimeter. Let me write all. Huh? Okay, do calculation later on. Now this, I think you are quite familiar. I just picked up. Find the minimum tension in any string. Will it be, if I switch off magnetic field, tension the both the strings will be same. If I switch on, when I switch on the tension, both the strings, will it be equal? No, that one, the ring is having a tendency to rotate due to torque due to dipole moment. The basic idea of this particular problem. There's a ring you take like this. So this is one rope. There's another rope. Now the weight mg will act here. Let the tensions in the string be T1 and T2. B bar is directed tangential to the plane of the ring and I is the current. So how m bar, m naught bar, that one will be directed. So what is the tendency of this particular ring? It can rotate about. Let me give the axis. This is y axis, that axis, x axis. This is the direction of current and m bar. Look at the, what is the tendency due to dipole moment? Torque due to dipole moment will be like this. We can do in any way. So now you have to ask question like, it's in equilibrium. Huh? Equilibrium. So as it is in equilibrium, so about what point you can define torque? You can define torque about any point, no? Able to make it out? I'm defining torque about the z-axis here. So then at equilibrium, T1 into R clockwise, torque due to dipole moment clockwise, then T2 into R anti-clockwise equals zero. And we know T1 plus T2 minus mg equals zero. Clockwise, I'll take it negative. So this should be equal to BI pi R square. Negative plus this will be T2 into R. So two equations to unknown. Solving this, we'll get the tension. Tell me like in which string tension will be minimum, left or right? sir, I will solve by mathematics. The one which is lower, I'll take it. Okay, that is fine. But you know enough of rotation mechanics idea. What is the tendency of this ring? It wants to rotate in clockwise, no? So therefore, this will be maximum, this will be minimum. Able to understand? So that, because if you change direction of current, then this will become minimum, this will become maximum. Or it'll solve the problem. The one which is lower, that is the minimum tension. Sometimes they may test you, like if both are having same stress, breaking stress. Clear this one? So when this is about to break, this is about to break. So what is the state of this? This will not break up. If this is about to break, what is the state of this? This will definitely will break up. So they'll bring elasticity into picture. Because same stress is there, no? What is the stress? Tension by area. So if they're having same stress, as I increase, keep on increase the current, tell me like which particular string will first break up? This will first break up. So they may bring some elastic ideas also. Can you solve it? I'll go for next one. Read the question. Small idea based. Let me take help of plane diagram. Now, through plane diagram, it will be a little bit easy for us through plane diagram. Yeah, this is what we have, radius AB. Everywhere the B is out of the plane here. Electron of charge E minus C and mass M starts out from outer surface of inner cylinder with an initial velocity V naught in radial direction. Okay, we'll assume here. Let it start like this. Radial direction. Now, directly get into magnetic force, B bar velocity. So how the force will act, the magnetic force will act in this direction. Okay, agree this. So how do it deviate? It will deviate. And what is telling? The maximum value of magnetic field up to which the electron will not hit the surface of outer cylinder. So what should happen to it now? It should move in such a way that it should just graze the outer surface and again it should hit back. It should just graze it. I think there's only possible thing which can.
What is that? Force should act the other side, no, sir.
What happened?
Sir, force should be in opposite direction, no, sir. No. It is a negative charge.
Okay, it'll come on that side, no? Okay, I'll do one thing. Okay, I'll invert this circle. It'll come in this way. Anyway, that one.
Sir, correct only, sir.
B bar out of the plane, no?
Out into the plane, no, sir.
Into the plane.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It is out of the plane only, sir.
Okay, I'll do one thing. I'll make B bar into the plane problem solved. Huh? So problem will become easier. Huh? Okay, now get into this one. So now, so B bar into the plane velocity. try to see this. This will be the situation. It has to graze and it has to come like this. And it will enter again. So definitely it will enter normally. So with same speed, what it left, it will come here. So how this velocity should be directed? So the radius of, so here the we'll take help of the force. This force is very important. Through that, what will happen? I will take out the center of this path. So I agree this. So this should be the radius. What to do after this? So this distance will be r, no? The distance is r. So this is O, this is C, this is P1, P2. What should be the OC should be equal to? And as this is 90 degree, this is A. I'll write all the symbols here. OP1 should be equal to A. Then CP1 is equal to CP2 should be equal to R. Okay, we have a triangle. We'll get a triangle. We'll take help of that triangle. We'll see this. This is A, this is R. What can be this distance OC? Should be B minus R. So I do have a right angle triangle. So B minus R whole square equal to A square plus R square. Let me solve for R. R square get cancelled, so B square minus A square by 2B equal to R. Then what is speed with which MV naught equal to QB? Is asking expression for V, no? So this is R equal to MV naught by EB. Let me substitute R, I'll get the value of V naught. I think somehow if you can assume the diagram, it's possible. This should be the speed. He's asking B, no? Just wait. Minimum field, no? Okay, B should be equal to MV naught, 2MV naught B by E into B square minus A square. Why that minimum word? The maximum value of magnetic field after which the electron will not hit the surface of outer cylinder. Let me increase further value of B. Definitely R will increase, no? Because R will decrease. Sorry, if I further increase the value of B, R will decrease, then it cannot hit. So that, then what happened? The trajectory will be somewhere like this. I'll scroll down. Okay, workout. This is a simple one. Okay, now come for this. Just now, previous problem, what we did, the similar idea, torque due to dipole moment should be balanced by torque due to it. See here, the biggest thing is formulas are very easy. The diagram understanding is something very difficult. What students are doing is like, so the field produced by bar magnet, we assume it to be uniform. That is what actually you have to try here. A 35 turn loop. Okay, that's okay. This. a 35 turn loop. So torque due to dipole moment, N I A into B. Area is given square coil. This should be equal to Mg into L by 2. So expression for current, Mg by 2N LB. No need of second thought, sir. Failed due to bar magnet. He himself has mentioned this is enough, no? Of course, we know field will be non-uniform between that, but here what happened? So in the location of the loop, we are assuming it to be uniform equal to 0.0550 Tesla, and you are proceeding it. Okay, next again, read this. Point O is here, the origin. Hope everyone is able to understand the diagram. So this is the first. Let me draw a circle. Okay, same diagram I'm putting. Okay, this one. Okay, now let's get into. So here is what? Okay, no. This is, so he's asking the field at point two. Now take help of the how to do this. So this is something. You can make problem this very simple. So shall we take like this, the field due to these two wires, okay, these four wires, 1, 2, 3, 4 will be same at O. And the field due to these four wires will be zero because the point lies on the axis. So what you calculate field due to all will contribute these two wires, 1, 2 and 3, 4 and 5, 6. How to calculate field due to, if you calculate field due to any one wire, I think this, if you are finding difficult, take help of this one, or take help of this one. So where do this point lies here? Then what is the formula? Mu naught I 4 pi d sine alpha plus sine beta. Sine beta, let it be zero. What is the sine alpha? Sine alpha, you can calculate this one. So you do one thing, just make a problem very simple. See now, okay, in exam, in that limited time thinking is what matters a lot, I feel. Okay, this distance is how much? 20. So I think alpha will be 45 degrees. And what is the beta? Beta will be zero. Current I, any direction, let us, so what is the formula now? Mu naught I 4 pi d sin alpha plus sin beta. Four root two pi d. What is d? D is this one. So next again we have a arc. So this arc will subtend an angle 90 degrees. So what is the total field at O will be due to sides 4 times due to each side plus 2 times due to arc. Okay, what is the formula due to arc? Mu naught I 2R, radius of this is R. Yeah, take it this one. Theta will be pi by 2 by 2 pi. Different geometric structures. Even you look at this, looks very simple. You look at the advance, them star shaped is what he has asked. Possibility of different shape by Bayer-Savart law can be asked. Be alert. I think I have answer. I'll check it. Not there. I don't have answer. Verify it. Let me take the next one. Don't scold me troubling with this lengthy question. I think we can make it. Some register that infinite network, no? So that is what I'm trying to bring here. Problem very simple. Somehow you understand what he has given. No need to semi-infinite wires, use it for entry and exit of current into this grid as shown in figure, which is an enlarged diagram to figure 2. Read question. I think some 5 minutes needed, because at least we have to first get the what is that diagram, conditions given. Now, what is the magnitude of B bar dot dl around the shown ampere loop is B is taken due to the grid and the feeding wires is X. Next again, the magnitude of B bar dot dl around the shown ampere loop if B is taken only due to entire grid excluding the feeding wire is Y. Right, if you feed this, how much of current will flow here actually? So here, if you feed at A, so what is the current that will flow here? If I send a current I by 4. When you feed at infinity, so here I by 4 will come. I by 4 plus I by 4 will be I by 2, no? So how much of current will pass through AB? It will be I by 2, what current that is entering. Okay, so what is the value of B bar dot dl? So how much of current here will be I by 2? So shall we go for mu naught I by 2, the value of x? No need to go in detail again, because already we have discussed this idea. So what is the current here will be I by 2. And we know what is the resistance here. If it is R, of the total grid will be R equivalent, will be R and R. R by 2 will be the effective resistance across AB. So I think at least I'll give some help. I think this is what we did like this, no? So here, if the current I enters, so how much here will be I by 2? This I by 2. Yeah. I'm giving int like this. At least now with this, you try to crack it. So what will be the current through the IAB is I by 2, no? So I think option A, no problem, all of you. I'm showing the idea like this. Yeah, option A, there's no problem. So it is, in fact, it'll be like this. Huh? Then what about next Y? How to calculate Y? If B is taken only due to entire grid, excluding the feeding wires. Excluding the feeding wires is Y.
Subtract.
Shall I subtract? I have to subtract, no? Excluding the feeding wires. Feeding wires, where are feeding wires? Shall we take these are feeding wires? Because it will also pass, no? So that mu naught I is what it should be subtracted from this particular thing, from the entire grid. Entire grid, what shall I do now? So what is the distance this will be? How much it is? A by 2, no? Point C is given A by 2. Well, I'll do one thing. I'll draw a diagram. At least you'll understand. This is AB. So this is the circle. A by 2. Now you go for. What should be the angle? It should be, I think, this should be the A by 2. I'll remove this circle one. First, let me do this. Okay, now come for this one. A by 2, this is A, this is A by 2. So what are alpha, beta? It should be, and what should be the current here? Current should be due to entire grid is telling around the shown ampere loop. B is taken only due to entire grid. Entire grid means what should be the current? I by 2 plus I by 2, I should show I. Will I agree, all of you? This is the thing. So first we'll calculate the B bar due to the grid. So what is the B bar due to grid? So how much you're going to write, this will be mu naught 4 pi a by 2 sine alpha plus sine beta. Due to value of b bar dot dl, b bar dot dl means what shall I remove now? Okay, this one, this will be, I think, okay, we'll do one thing. This is mu naught I value is needed, no? What shall we have to adjust? Pi A, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Pi A. So pi A, so this will be mu naught by 2. 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. So this will become equal to how much it will be? I will be there. Yeah, this is due to, shall we say, due to grit. Due to long feeding wire. Of course, small gap is there. I think it doesn't matter. These are the feeding wires. Okay, this is the point P. Okay, due to feeding wire, how much it is? Mu naught. I think we have to subtract this one. So the resultant is asking. So what is y? Y should be equal to b bar dot dl. DL due to feeding wire. Yeah. So this should be mu naught. This is a grid, no? Oh, yeah. Mu naught I by root 2 minus mu naught I. Why option?
Sir, first we found out the B dot DL due to whole system, na, sir. We can subtract due to feeding wires. It will be mu naught I minus mu naught I by root 2. Small region also we should consider.
Oh, in this I by 2 will be there, no? Okay, and due to feeding wire means again, I should subtract this quantity. Oh, I think I'm trying to explain more. Due to feeding wire means due to total grid minus this wire AB. Total is how much? Mu naught I.
Not I by 2, sir.
Excluding the feeding wire. B bar dot DL due to feeding wire, how much it should come?
Mu naught I minus 1 by root 2.
No, the value, what is y? Y is defined as due to taken only due to entire grid, excluding the feeding wires. Only now entire grid we have calculated. Huh? In that I should subtract due to feeding wires, no? Due to feeding wires, we should calculate how much, no? Okay, this one, yeah. Feeding wires are these things, huh? These are feeding wires, no? Okay, this will be... It is as good as long
mu
wire.
I minus
no, sir. Mu naught I by root 2. Be mu naught I into 1 minus 1 by root 2. That small region is also there, sir, from A to B.
Okay, this has
to be subtracted.
So how much you'll get? Mu naught I minus?
Mu naught I into 1 minus 1 by root 2.
This much, huh?
Yes, sir.
So what is Y now?
X minus of this value.
Mu naught I 1 minus 1 by root 2.
X is mu naught I by 2 now, sir.
X is mu naught i by 2.
From x you should subtract this value.
No, value of y is what I'm substituting this one. I think, okay, wait. And I'll move this little bit down. Yeah. Feeding value this much, mu naught i 1 minus 1 by 2. Y should be from total mu naught i by 2.
Totally should subtract this value.
Totally, I should subtract this one. Okay, I think I'll make it here. Symbols. What is y? Y should be total. How much it is? Mu naught.
I by two
minus this one. Yeah. Mu naught I 1 minus 1 by root 2. We are getting
minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by root 2, sir.
1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by root 2. Okay, any Ampere circuit law? Just I think somehow you have to understand the situation given. Okay, let I have one more. Okay, this is, yeah. Two very small problems I brought it. A coil of entrance carries a current I, field at a distance x from center of loop on its axis is B. Write the value of integral, not integral of B bar dot dl, you say closed path. Line integral is asking, not closed line integral. It is having n turns. Okay, now see this. This will be the ring. Okay, let it carry current I. How B bar from minus infinity to plus infinity, the value of line integral. So we know the B bar due to this here, it will be in the same direction. Of course, B will be not be same, it will be different at different points on the axis. The axis. He's asking, write the value of line integral from minus infinity to this particular thing. So the Amperean loop I should bring. So the Amperean loop. Actually, I should merge that line. We'll do one thing. I will. That blue color dotted line only, let it be Amperean loop. Shall I take like this? The Amperean loop is asking what is the value of B bar dot DL from A to B. This is a minus infinity to plus infinity. This distance is what? Infinity. Even this also infinity. I think I can show only till here. So there are n turns, are there coil of n turns. Now what is the value of B bar dot DL for AB? It should be non-zero because B bar is now. What about B bar here? Because it is at infinity, you know, what do you expect B bar here? Should be zero. B bar here is zero. What about B bar here? The way he's asking question, no? So on the axis, okay. Because see, we know value of B bar varies. I'll integrate from minus into, okay, I'll get some answer. But here B bar is zero. First of all, we don't know how much value. So can we calculate here B bar? That to at infinity it is. So what about B bar here? And we should calculate B bar here. So I think I'll give points 1, 2, 3 and this is 4. We have to.
What is the need of B bar there, sir? P3.
I'm using Ampere circuit law. If you don't want to use Ampere circuit law, directly integrate, you'll get the answer. So either way, call this is equal to alpha. What is alpha? Alpha is equal to B bar dot dx. So what is B bar value? So mu naught ni r square plus x square to the power of 3/2 dx. There's a one formula, you can apply it and solve it, no? Fine. Because everywhere B bar will be parallel to dx. This is what you need to do. Can we solve this by same Ampere circuit law? Because there's an Ampere loop. With the net current enclosed mu naught ni. Somehow if you can calculate B bar due to these sides at P2, P3, P4, subtract in that, we'll get the required answer. So what can be the value of B bar dot DL for this side? For that, we should know what is B bar. Are you getting my idea? So I'm trying to. So like this also, we can think nothing wrong, no? Instead of taking help of mathematics, I'm trying to avoid mathematics here. Will it be feel that P3, P2, P4 will it be zero or non-zero? I think we'll start with that asking question. If it is non-zero, then how to calculate? Or we cannot calculate. Limits are only will do by integration.
Zero it will be. Median value will be zero.
P2, P4 will be zero. What about P3?
Zero.
All of you agree with this answer or any explanation we have to bring it? So actually what did happen? So actually we are thinking in terms of finite. So even this distance is what? Will be infinity, no?
That's why it will be zero.
This will be zero. So here this will also be at infinity. Actually this distance I'm putting infinity. Okay, I think it's understood now. So no need that integration. I think this is what the Ampere loop you are going to draw. So this is what happened at infinity. It is. This is also at infinity. So here B bar is zero, here also B bar is zero. It may be very difficult to analyze this in this way of thinking. You solve this, you'll get the answer same what we are getting. So therefore now, what is the net current enclosed by this B bar dot DL? I'll proceed like this by the loop. This should be equal to BACD. Take like this. So integral B bar dot DL A to B. Okay, fine. So this is what mu naught Ni. This we don't know. This is what we are supposed to calculate, no? And all these are zero. Why they are zero? Because B is zero. This is DA. Okay, no. So this will become mu naught Ni. These are very famous objective questions. Huh? So our answer will be mu naught Ni. So explore all the possibilities through mathematics or through Amperian law. Okay, one more similar. Take this one. Same condition. Minus infinity to plus infinity. On x-axis is asking now. I think some tell me like shall we assume because they're long wires, no? So shall we do one method? We'll take a distance r. Because anyway, it's a symmetric, no? I'll find out what is the value of B bar dot DL for this. But how many are there? Infinite number of very long current carrying wires. Infinite number. And parallel to z-axis as shown. Infinite number of very long current carrying wires. And the current is 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 16, like that. Here also same thing. So what is the best method? Shall we calculate field at this point? Because due to this wire, I'm trying to make you to first think, okay, let's assume this is a wire. How did it produce field here perpendicular to it? Now, next we have another wire. So this is 1 ampere. This is 0.5 ampere. So what about field produced by this will be in this direction perpendicular to this? So let me call this is 1, 2. This is B2, this is B1, no? Oh, sorry, this should be due to this B1, it'll be like this here. Is asking the value of B bar dot DL. I think this will be a very difficult thing if you try to think in this way, what I'm giving diagram. So first I'll find out due to this. Next again, that one. This will be very lengthy mathematics. Any alternative method? Ampere's circuit law. how to apply Ampere circuit law. Just now we did for only one wire, no? Now here you have to bring many wires into the picture. So again, as himself is telling infinity, no? So therefore, so if I shall I put in the diagram itself? This is the Amperean loop I'm going to plot. I'm going to end up everything in the diagram. Okay, fine. So this is the value of DL. Okay, due to minus infinity to plus infinity. What do we expect? This will be infinity. This will also be infinity. So what all field will be? Now only what is the magnet field at these sides? Field here will be zero. Field here will be zero. Here it'll be non-zero. Okay, let's write the Amperean loop. B bar dot DL. This should be equal to B bar dot DL AB. These are not just theoretical questions. When we go for coaxial cables, no, there it is widely used here. So this value is what needed. So half of them are enclosed, no? This is what our thing, that one. So AB or minus infinity to plus infinity. This will be zero plus zero plus zero. How to proceed next? This one. What all the field contributed? What happened? Only the total field is what is asking. No? But what we are calculating is actually off of it. Am I right? Because even this side also will contribute here. Even this side also will contribute. So first we'll write due to this one. Mu naught 1 plus mu naught 1 by 2 due to this one. Now, again it'll be contributed, but this side also, again, one more you should assume here. This will be at infinity. So A, B, C, D, this will be E, F. I think I'm... Then what all I should write? Due to upper loop, I'll write it. Due to lower loop, I'll change symbols here. Yeah, I think, okay, we clone due to lower loop it will be AB, then BE, EF, FA. This will be 0 plus 0 plus 0. This will be due to upper loop. Sh- Shall I add up this? If I add up these two, two minus infinity to plus infinity, b bar dot dl. Due to lower loop, so this should be, so our question is only this much, yeah? 1/2. Okay, let's add up all the things. I'll proceed with the mathematics now. So due to first upper loop, it will be 1 + 1/2 + 1/4 + 1/8 and so on. Due to lower loop, 1/2 + 1/4 + 1/8 + 1/16 and so on. Anybody value?
Mu naught by 2.
Mu naught should be there, no?
Yeah.
3 mu naught by 2. Huh?
Yes,
see, I think now are you getting now? So there's.
Why did you take 2 times, sir?
I'll add up these two.
1/2 should be.
No, actually not 2. No, I'm not taking 2. This 2, why it has come? See, actually, wall will produce field here. These wires as also these wires, no? Okay, this one. So first I calculated the B bar dot DL due to this, these currents. Next, I'll calculate B bar dot DL due to these currents. Then I should add up those. I added up here. So that's
sir, why did you take 1/2? 1/2 times the
year, huh? No, two times, no, this two I'll send it here.
Huh? Sir, why are you getting 2 times? Only 1 time.
No, I'll add up adding equation 1, 2. I think okay. You are start from here. Because our answer was asked this one, no? Say you mean to say, sir, why don't you solve equation 1? But the total field is due to both, no? Due to upper wires as well as lower wires.
So the result which we want is 2 times the integral of minus infinity to infinity bdl, no, sir.
But due to whom? Due to these two, all these wires?
Sir, addition of both.
Addition of both, that's what I did. I added equation 1 and 2. This is due to the value of this is only due to, I think the symbol you are getting confusion, sir. Here, this one. This is what we are calculating. This is upper. What this we are calculating is due to lower. So if I add up both, then we have to do this one. Or else you can, this you can give any other symbol.
You want the value due to upper and lower, sir. Both.
Together. So I should add up this one.
Sir, the result which we need is 2 times this value, no? I mean, the LHS part.
By 2 should not be there, you are telling, huh?
Yes, sir.
Infinite number of very long current carrying wire is placed on y axis, parallel that axis as shown in figure. B bar dot DL on x axis.
A kind of superposition type.
Superposition, I did this one. Okay, you mean to say this two should not be there?
Yes, sir.
I'll remove this two then. Answer then also?
I will get 3 mu naught.
3 mu naught. Huh?
Sir.
What? Where is the option? Oh. Okay, we'll do one thing. First, like this, I'll call some b dash. B double dash, I'll write it. Huh? So when I add up these two, this one. So this will become okay, no, according to the due to upper loop, this is due to this two should not be there, yeah. So we are getting only 3 mu naught. What about the options? I think exactly we are getting more than that one, no? I think he's asking correct question. I think what we did is right, but what is the question? Total field is asking infinitely on x-axis. Both will contribute. Okay. I think what we did is correct. And I'll make changes here. I think the best alternative is Ampere's circuit law only. We can't do any by Biot-Savart law, such numericals. Huh? Just be careful. Any questions can be asked in advance of this kind. Okay, I think tomorrow we'll continue. Remaining few more good problems are there. Okay, thank you all of you.